Well, I've come all this way, and I'm at Ham Street Bridge, and I'm on the other side of the garden centre. I think you can just about see the sign up there, and I thought myself, I'll give it a try for the first time, but it is almost impassable. And if I show you why, that it's just all weeded up. So it's a shame. Loads of skaters and everything else, but there's no way really that I'd be paddling for all that lot. And up further, it's even worse. So there we go. There's the Royal Military Canal. And this was dug to stop the French, so I understand. Well, it also stops any canoe or kayak at the moment. Loads and loads of lilies all in flower up there, but I don't think I'd have a very easy time passing that. I think it would be really, really hard graft. I don't know how this was expected to stop the French. Might be they thought they couldn't swim. I don't know. Let's have a look at the other side of the bridge. Works out a nice walk here, because you can walk right the way along the canal by the seams of it. This side, on first inspection, seems a bit better. Let's go down and have a look. So there's the bridge. Easy to launch here, got to be honest. Look, easy to launch a canoe, and the parking's dead easy. But same problem. Reeds and lilies and everything else. Look at that lot. Reasonable depth. Oh, look at that. Got some, I don't know if you can see that, it's a dragonfly there. Very nice. Oh, look at these. Pond skaters and look at that, amazing. Amazing the life that you've got in here. But unfortunately, not particularly any good for me with a kayak. So it looks like I've had a wasted journey. What a shame. Very nice, but for dragonflies and water boatmen, and quite a nice ride out, to be honest with you. Oh, it's got some nice fish in there that I can see. Very small fish. I should think there's some nice big ones in here and all. Plenty of food for them. But I'm afraid that's going to be it. And such a lovely day too. Been ideal for a paddle. I'm going to the other side now. As you can see, you know, this is the middle of nowhere. So I thought I'd try and have a look at this other one and see if I could get launched from there. Like a witch tree there. Dear, oh dear. This is amazing, very nice though. Hope you're enjoying this. Aha, here's the church. Got to be worth having a look at, isn't it? So here we are, we're at St Rumwald's Church at Bonnington. So this is it, and this is where the launch place should be. So it should be quite interesting. We'll have a look. Good old pasty, and of course water. Oh, and a little drink to give me a boost. That goes in there. So out we go from the bank, and I haven't got a clue which way to go. All I know is that the other way was totally unnavigable. So I think the easiest way is to try this one. But where I was before, Bonnington, that entrance there was fine to get onto the kayak, but to paddle would have been impossible because it was just a total solid mass of lilies with no way through at all, whereas at least here
in the middle, I would suspect somebody has been through here before, or there's been some craft of some description, because obviously it's clear here, and it's not because it's too deep, because there are lilies actually growing in this area, so it doesn't present a problem to them. And the water is quite clear. I can actually see down to the bottom. Amazing. But something's been up here and chewed all this lot up. Interesting to note that the trees on the left-hand side there seem to be equally spaced. So I don't know if they've been planted at all. You've got nothing on the right where the farmer's fields are, but on the left there, the trees seem to be not higgledy-piggledy, but actually planted in sort of designated spots. But as usual, no noise except a plane and the wind. And me! Right, you got my ugly mug there. Very, very hot day. But to be honest with you, I'm not exactly worried. I can cool down by putting my gloves into the water, and that cools you down quite nicely. I've got the sleeves on my cycling top pushed up, but still important to wear the right gear. So I've got a pair of polyester tracksuit bottoms on, which would dry out if they got wet quickly. I've got a cycling shirt on at the top, which again is very light and breathable. The only thing that's not breathable really is the life jacket or life preserver, whatever you want to call it. And of course the keg, the red keg seems to keep the heat in, although it's supposed to be breathable. But it does keep the drips off you, although after this little experiment, I'll see what happens, because I haven't got a drip on the spray skirt yet. And that's not down to my good paddling, I can assure you. So perhaps today might have been a good idea to have gone out without the keg on. Another big fish. Whoa. God, it makes you jump. I'll tell you, when they jump, it makes me jump. I think they're sunning themselves. Anyway, let's feel the temperature of the water. No, it's not very cold. Still much of the same. It doesn't change here. And obviously, because it's a canal as such, it's been dug in. So when the soil was removed, of course, it was put on the banks. And I suspect that that's one of the reasons that you haven't got much of a view. But absolutely gorgeous. What a day. And this is the fifth time I've been in my own kayak, or been in a kayak, and it hasn't rained. How about that? And I would suspect that it's not going to today, because the sky is absolutely blue and gorgeous. So I think I'm going to be lucky today. The other interesting thing that's worth a mention, as we're being talking about nature and God knows what else, of what I'm seeing, there's two dragonflies mating there, a jewel if you like. The other thing I was going to mention was that I'm a bit annoyed because pond skaters are definitely faster than me. I had a little race with one before just back there, and they can half motor, they really can. I don't know if they use their wings as well, because I know that they can fly. But I was paddling, I thought, put a bit of spurt on, see how I go. And this little skater was in front of me, scared out of his life he was. And off he went, he was going straight away from me. And I couldn't keep up. And I thought to myself, that's a bit of a cheek. Little tiny blooming pond skater, and he's faster than I am. And then I gave up. So there you go. All good fun. Loads of dragonflies. Absolutely loads, because I don't know if you can see it, but obviously some fish that live in here get pretty big. And there's one over there, just to the left of the front of the boat. I'll try and get over a bit closer, but that is big. That is big. Look at the size of that. Give you an idea, I put my paddle near it. You get an idea on the size of it. That is some big fish. Wow. So I think that very nice to have a fishing license in here. Crumbs, that is a big fish. I'm smelling a bit now. I don't know what it is. I haven't got a clue. But that is, wow, that's big. I bet he's had a few other fish for dinner. These lilies all growing here, lovely pink lilies. Pay a fortune for this lot in garden centres. And here they're growing for nothing. Good lord. This was round. The wind has picked up a little bit. But other than that, it's not too bad. If anything, it seems like it's a bit more navigable down here. So I made the right decision to move on from the original launch point quite a way down now. And what's the time? I can keep my watch on because it is waterproof. It's 1:25. It took me a bit longer to get here than I expected. A bit further away. Obviously I anticipated going to the nearer launch point, however ended up coming further down, but I think there's a few more folks that have chewed this lot up, because you'll notice that the lilies are gradually receding towards the edge of the bank, which more than likely says that that's because there's more river type traffic, or people tend to try and get up here, although there's still plenty of stuff sticking up and just below the surface. Interesting. Only one fisherman, I can't believe it. One fisherman for a place like this. Wow. Just paddling gently. As you can see. And there's some hills in the background over there. So it looks like we're going between sort of the downs, if you like. Absolutely amazing. But just nice, gentle paddling. I can't see this ever getting crowded, can you? Amazing. I'm in the frame. Well, yesterday I ended up doing the garden. That's a massive box hedge, giving that a trim, and also all the grass and all the cuttings and everything else, all that to be done. And it was a right old game. And I got up this morning, I can honestly say I was aching, and that did rather put me off coming paddling in the kayak. Anyway, I decided to get myself into gear and managed to make it down, and I'm just taking it easy. There's no way I'm putting any effort into this. I'm just enjoying myself, paddling along, and on a beautiful day like this, it certainly beats gardening. It's amazing. It really is lovely. And that was a woodpecker. Ooh, another thing I've got to mention. My tummy's rumbling. And there's nowhere, as you can see, that I can get out of the kayak. And you have to get out of your kayak to get your grub in the back. I managed to get my bottle of drink out. Oh, definitely needed a boost. So I've got that out. But me cheese and pickle sandwiches and me Cornish pasty will have to wait, and my tummy will have to keep rumbling. Because there is absolutely nowhere here that I can get out of the kayak. Oh dear. So, I'll keep on going. I'm about to find somewhere. The other thing I must do as well is that I must bring some money with me. I bought the phone, keys and God knows what else, but I don't know why I didn't bring any money with me. So the unfortunate part about it is, if I found a pub at the end of this and I think to myself, oh, that'd be nice to have a pint, I couldn't have one. So there's another lesson. So can't paddle too deep in lilies, number one. Need some money, number two. And number three, just enjoy it. Wow. Still getting a few glimpses of some fish, nice size. Some cuttings that have been done, obviously by fishermen I would think, so that they can get down to the riverbank and fish. There we go, one fisherman. Alright. There's some beautiful fish in here. I was quite surprised. I've seen one about that big. I couldn't believe it.
Yeah, sharp,
amazing. Right. It's a nice river to fish. I'll leave you in peace. Set myself a goal as well. Can't just keep paddling willy-nilly. What's the time now? It's 2:10 now. As I started off late, I don't want to push my luck too far. So I think that if I turn around anything about 2:45, I think that should be suitable. Because I'll be going into wind and, well, I don't know if you can call it into current, but obviously it all adds to the problem. So I think that would be a good time to go. Don't want to push it too far today either, because of all that gardening yesterday. Isn't it marvellous? It's not the kayaking that world wears me out, it's the gardening. Huh. Crazy, isn't it? We got an obstacle. So how do I get round this? Oh, that's a shame. Looks like it's going to curtail my activities anyway. Unless I can fight over the lily pads or something. I don't think I've got much chance the other side. So I think this is about the only place that I can possibly do it. But take it easy. Be ready for anything. Let's fight round this. All the old lily leaves. Hey, it's like going up the Amazon again. That's it, I'm round. That's it, I'm round. As you can see, not an ideal navigable situation. Right over the canal, but I managed to get by that little gap there. Voila! Let's turn around. Get going again. All that was here. I'll tell you what, that's all the French needed to do. Cut down a tree or two, let it fall over, and then after that go across it. I'm sure there was more trees then than what there are now. So I can't see how much strategic value this was. There you go. Listen to that. Just the wind in the trees and the wind rustling the rushes. Let's pull some nice deep strokes. There we go. How we doing? Woo-hoo! One, two, one, two. There we go, let's try again. Yeah, I've done the bell one, that ain't bad. Is opening out a hell of a lot more, so obviously this is getting more major now. I should think that there'd be a weir or something here to regulate the flow. It might be a lock or something further down. This is getting quite wide now, but the other thing is that this is a very hot day. They're predicting sort of over 25, and I've got my cag on and also my life jacket, which is riding up at the back. I've got the wrong one, really. I think I should get a proper kayaking life jacket. It'll be more comfortable. But other than that, I'm not overly hot. I'm warm, but I'm not overly hot. And all I've got to do is to cool myself down. It's just dip my hands in the water and funnily enough, that does cool you down. Of course, if you wanted to do a flip dip, then an Eskimo roll would be the order of the day, but I don't think so, and I'm certainly not qualified to do that. But it's great. It's great. And I've still got the wind on my back. And the time at the moment is 25 past 2. So I've been paddling, if you want to call it that. I suppose about an hour and a half, something like that. Hour and a half, hour and three quarters. So this is great. And still the only sound that I get is aircraft. I can see some houses down here in the distance. So I think I'll set that as a goal. Otherwise I could end up going too far down. And when I get down here, I'll see if I can find out where I am. Because you always think you've gone further than you have. That's the advantage, I suppose, of having one of these GPS phones, because you can check exactly where you are. And of course it would work on a kayak. And as long as you kept it in the waterproof container, which I've got on deck there, that would be fine. So you could actually see where you were, whereas at the moment, I really haven't got an idea where I am. So hopefully I'll find out. Right, I've been told that I'm at West Hyde. So at least we can check that on the map. And apparently I can't get any further now unless I get out of the canoe and walk it over. So I don't know if this is a lock or a weir or what, but West Hyde. Gonna be a bit weary about this, just in case. If I've got water funneling out of here, I don't want to get too close to it. Is it a lock? It doesn't say. There's no signs at all here. No signs at all. There's nothing saying navigation. There's no steps. It's obviously totally automatic. And these are always a bit dodgy because when you have rain or anything like that, they can open up quite quickly at any time. There's no way that I can see to get out and walk around. There's a walkway over there. But I don't really want to. Is that a pontoon for getting out? No, that's for letting water through again. No, not a chance of getting out. So I'm going as far as I can. So now got to West Hyde. And now it's back again. And what's the time? 25 to 3. So that's going to take a while to get back anyway, isn't it? And I should think it's not going to be so easy. So, gone down to West Hyde. So we can have a look now and see what the distance is. There was a guy up there walking his dogs. He's the guy who I asked. Whereabouts we were, and he kindly said that this was West Hyde and you can't get any further here. You have to get out and climb round and go over. Have to say that with the wind now, we're going into wind. You can see on the canal there, you can see all the ripples. So I'm paddling into wind effectively every now and again, and it's knocked a bit off my speed, but not too much. I'm still doing it very easily, not hard at all. hopefully the commentary will come out a bit better because I'm trying to speak a little bit louder and into the microphone a bit. This is where I think there were some fishermen down here. Not many, but past a few. But now coming out of wind a bit. And still making, you know, fair headway. Not a problem at all. We're coming up to the tree in the distance that's fallen over and blocking the canal. And I have to say, I still have not seen a kingfisher. I was hoping to see one, but obviously down here, they're, for some unknown reason, not as plentiful. Quite surprised. It's quiet enough, there's nothing to scare them away. But might be it's not the right kind of environment for them, I don't know. There's certainly enough fish. So for a staple diet, I would have thought that would have been ideal. But there could be predators, I don't know, sparrowhawks or something like that that could take them. But there you go. Bit more effort required going against the wind and upstream. Not a lot. Not a little bit of the speed down, but nothing that really is dramatic. So we're coming up to this fallen tree now, and I'll have to navigate around that, like I did before. So at least I know where to go now, so it's not such a problem. Right, the wind is a lot stronger. It seems to have picked up a bit this afternoon. So as the microphone on this thing faces the other way, I can only hope that it's picking up what I'm saying. Here we go. Go through here, and then the fishermen are just along the bank on the left-hand side. Here we go. Soon stops you, the old lilies, though. Here we go. Keep on going. That's it, keep the momentum up, come out, and that's it, I'm clear. And you can see the low bridge in the distance there. It's quite amazing though, what speed you can get up to in these things, really. See the bits of quickly going on. Making good headway home, or back anyway. It's 3:05 at the moment, and we're not doing bad. Just taking it nice and easy, just watching the dragonflies. And it's amazing, you know, the lilies are starting to close up now, the white ones are anyway. They seem to know when it's full sun. And after full sun, they seem to know and they start closing up. And a bit of wind here, you can see it on the canal surface. It's not making a lot of difference to me though, to be honest. But I suppose really the only windage that I've got is my body. The canoe itself, or the kayak itself, is going into wind, so it's not really a problem. Plenty of wildlife around, like in the shape of pond skaters, dragonflies of all descriptions and colours and sizes. But I haven't seen a kingfisher. Seen a red kite. I have to say I've seen a red kite. So that's something. The land rises up on the right quite quickly, and there's two woodpeckers just disappeared down there as well. Thought I heard them. I actually saw them flying, you can't mistake them. Listen to that. Yakking away it is. That was amazing. I hope we come out. The lilies are starting to close in a bit more now. So, I'm quite a way back already. Just taking it nice and steady. But as the channel starts to close up, I know that I'll be getting back to our starting point. Skaters still amaze me. They are so fast. They're certainly faster than I am. If they want to go, they can really go. There's loads of them here. The channel's just starting to close up a little bit more here. It's still not a problem. And interesting to see the bees visiting the orange small lilies there. I don't know how they'd fare if they fell off, but they seem to be quite content to settle on the lilies on the water surface. But they're quite a carpet, really. A bit more wind here again. As you can see, you can always tell when you're going into the wind. You can see all the old ripples there. I feel it in my face, but it's cooling me down as well. So that's quite nice. Not as bad as you think. It can be an advantage. Not if you are on a long paddle, but I don't know what the out and return on this one will be. Till I have a look, I'm not going to know. Just seems to be little patches that you get the wind, like it's reasonably calm here for some unknown reason. It might be the tree. Yeah, it could be the tree, because it's coming from that sort of left-hand side area. And then all of a sudden, when we clear the shadow of the tree, we come into the waves again, and a lot more here. You can see the sun glinting off the surface as it's being roughed up. Enough of that. Just talking to a guy, he got an inflatable kayak, and he was thinking about doing the same thing on here, and I've recommended for him to go on to the River Medway, which he didn't realise was accessible up in Tonbridge, and do the Tonbridge to Yalding run, which I think is superb. It takes something to beat that. One of the disadvantages that you've got on the Royal Military Canal is the fact that because it's a canal, the banks are built up. So as you can see, you can't see over the banks. So in the distance you can see, if I bring that round, in the distance you can see as it goes up, but here you can't. And even over there you see, it's just banks. So although it's quite good, it's not the same as say the River Medway, where you can see out a lot more. It's very peaceful and tranquil, and it's got a loveliness all of its own, but it's not the same as the River Medway, and I don't think any canals are. Anyway, enough waffle. Hiya.
Hi mate.
Yeah, I'm sorry, I'm just waffling myself on the camera. Bad habit, I'm afraid. I would suspect I haven't got much further to go, to the church, and the reason that I say that is because one thing that's apparent is that the lilies are closing in, and that was what I had. I spoke to a couple of fishermen down there who've got a canoe, an inflatable one, and they've done this from the garden centre, which is the one that I tried first of all, but they just paddled through the lily pads, whereas I didn't. I came down to the next launch way, i.e. by the church, but I don't think I'm that far away now, because once the lilies are going almost all across the canal, I know that the church can't be far away. But it's been a good time out, and I'm certainly not stressed, and it hasn't been hard at all. What's the time? Let's have a look. It's 4 o'clock now. So there we go, and I've stopped and had a chat for about 10 minutes with those people. All good fun. God, there's some fish in here. There's some real whoppers. Good Lord. Stop again. Oh. The lilies definitely slow you down. No two ways about that. You've got to creep in the clear patch, because if you don't, you can feel them hit the bottom of the kayak and slow it down. It's surprising, really. And you can hear them when they hit the bottom sometimes. So there you go. Trying to stay in the main channel area, if you can call it a main channel area. And as I say, I don't think I'm too far away now. You see the fish jumping every now and again when you come up and you disturb them. But then you get it sort of open up into areas like this where you've got a load of clear water. No problems at all. It's quite strange, really. Ah, there we are. In the distance is our starting point. So that's the church. How about that? So, on the home leg now. Getting nearer all the time. Plowing through the lilies. Keeping the strokes quite light and certainly not deep, going through those lily pad areas so that I don't wick anything up and it doesn't rip the paddle out of my hands, because they're quite strong. So I'm coming up to the pillbox, which you can just about see ahead. To the right of the front of the kayak there, and the church lies just beyond that, and that'll be my trip, which has been absolutely great. Still making quite good headway. Tilt it. One thing about this, that it is so easy. The paddling is easy, it really is. And the only way that I got a bit whacked out was yesterday doing the damn gardening. You know, do the gardening, get whacked out, go for a paddle and do God knows how many miles, and it just doesn't affect you, because it's no real effort. It's not like running or anything like that. You certainly don't expend the effort in a kayak that you do when you're even walking, so you can cover quite vast distances. The Indians had it right. Well, there's the church. You can just about see it through the trees there, and it is an old church, isn't it? It's not very large at all. But of course that would have been on the French side, had they invaded during the Napoleonic Wars? Very inconsiderate, I think. I'd have thought that they would have built the canal the other side and kept the church on the English side. How about that? And there's me mug down there. You can see it just through the trees there. The red citron. Nice and easy to park. I can recommend this as a site. Very easy to park and launch. And I'm no expert. I've only been in the thing five times, in a kayak five times. So I think that my view would be valid for an absolute beginner. So, okay, I'm a bit overdressed, but I haven't overheated. So there you go, keeping the right gear on rather than throwing it off, i.e. The cycling top, my keg, and of course my life jacket over the top of that. You'd think that I'd be cooking. Plus I've got the gloves on. But the gloves are an advantage because you can dip them in the water and they can get them soaking wet, and by doing so that helps to keep you cool. Right, we turn in here. Here's the little bridge. And now I've got the fun of getting out of the kayak, which is always hard because your legs tend to go asleep a little bit. So I think I'll be prudent, and I think I'll take the camera off and put it on the bank, just in case. Right, I'll whack in here in between the reeds. That'll do me very nicely. Oh, that's it. See my face now. So there you go. A nice little round trip. Excellent. Enjoyable. And I've done as much as you can go. As much as you can do here. So if you want to have a bit of fun, then have a go.